Hello, this is Kevin from Inquality with a look at the JK Audio AutoHybrid IP2 and how to configure it for use with the sip.audio service. First of all, visit the IP address of the unit. If it's behind a NAT router, then make sure you're on a computer on the same network as the unit. You'll be presented with this call management interface and click on Audio. First of all, you want to choose the Opus codec from this list on the left-hand side and click Enable so that it goes onto the list on the right-hand side, and then move it up to the top of the list because that is our preferred codec for use with the sip.audio service. You'll see that our second favourite codec is there underneath, which is G.722. Click on Save to save the changes and click on the Accounts tab. For one of these accounts, we want to enter sip.audio. And then for our display name, we can put Auto Hybrid. For the username, we'll enter the SIP account, which we've set up for the device at the sip.audio website. And for the domain, we'll enter sip.audio. We'll check the domain registration box and we'll enter the password, which we've set up for that account. Click on Topology and check the Stun box and click on Advanced, and for the proxy enter proxy.sip.audio, and you might want to check this Keep Alive box if you're behind a NAT and you find that the Auto Hybrid isn't staying registered to the sip.audio service. Click on Save and Enable and Register, and we also need to restart the SIP service on the device. You'll see it now says proxy registered in the account status box. And if I go back to the call management tab, I can now call myself on IPDTL. Type in the sip.audio address associated with my IPDTL account and click on call. And in IPDTL here, I have an incoming call. I can click the green box to answer. And you can now hear the audio looping back through the Auto Hybrid device and back to IPDTL. Likewise, I can hang up the call there, and in the IPDTL dial pad, I can type in Auto Hybrid, which is the sip.audio account associated with the Auto Hybrid device. And if I want, I can also add sip.audio there to be sure and click the dial button. If I go back to the Auto Hybrid, you'll see I have a call ringing and I can click the call button to answer. And once again, you hear my audio going from IPDTL out to the Auto Hybrid, which has got a loop cable, which is why we're hearing it coming back into IPDTL. You can hear the Opus audio there restricted to 25 kilobits per second. And we do hope that JK Audio will consider increasing that at some point in the future. I can click drop and drop the call. You'll find much more information regarding configuring devices for use with the sip.audio service in the sip.audio knowledge base. Just go to sip.audio/knowledge base. Thanks for watching.